I am Kristen Rupar. My fiance's name is Rashawn. We're perfect for each other. I like to be different from everybody else. Pretty much every bride has a white dress. I feel that I should have something different. I like the color red. It's a sexy color. And I don't want to be like every bride.
Kristen loves this look, but what will her parents think?
Hello. Do you like it? I do think it takes guts to wear a red dress. I don't think all women could pull it off.
And the red isn't the only surprise Kristen has in store for her wedding guests.
Wow. You look amazing.
Does the fiancé know about this?
He knows that it's red. That's all he knows. He doesn't know what it looks like, so he's gonna be surprised.
I'm Melanie Tambo, and my fiance's name is Adam Ross. We've been together for 11 years.
This bride has a very sporty vision of her wedding day.
Our theme is hockey. We're playing hockey in our wedding dresses.
You're playing hockey in your wedding dress.
Yes. So my dress needs to be flexible for that aspect.
Unusual request. This is quite a challenge.
Will Melanie's outrageous request be problematic?
I can't even move. Like, I feel like a penguin. Raising my arms and moving my feet is the test to make sure that I'm able to do all the activities I want to do on my wedding day. This dress is not passing the test.
If you want mobility in your dress, that's fine. But remember, this is formal attire, not workout wear. There's only so much you can do in a wedding gown.
Oh, yeah. You gotta do the snow test.
The beading underneath the arms, playing hockey, I'm gonna scratch my arms like crazy. I would have a rash by the end of the day.
And it looks like this outrageous request is going downhill fast.
I don't like this dress. It doesn't pass the test, so I won't be able to skate in it. It's too frilly.
Will Melanie finally score with this one?
What do you think about it?
Just not, like, I'm not getting that. Oh my goodness, this is my wedding dress. I'm not excited about it.
Mixing sports and satin is an easy way to end up in the penalty box. And with such an outrageous request, it's no surprise that Melanie leaves without a gown.
All right.
Okay, we'll have to make another appointment.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks. My name is Marnie. My fiance's name is Alexander. I fell in love with him the second I saw him.
Today, this bride is getting fitted for a very one-of-a-kind wedding dress.
My wedding dress is blue and white seersucker. It's a gutsy move for me, I guess, in a way to wear the dress. You know what? It shows my character and who I am.
I've never even heard of a bride who wanted a seersucker gown before. It's a thin, light fabric with a crinkled surface and a striped pattern. And if a bride is this outrageous, chances are she's also picky enough to turn small imperfections into major problems.
Wow.
Gorgeous.
Everyone seems to love the dress, but the bride is second-guessing the seersucker straps.
What is wrong with your dress?
Look what she's doing now. What are you doing?
It's too tight. You're gonna like...
Okay, if I make it loose, it's gonna fold by itself.
I need someone who's been in a wedding dress recently.
Alterations manager Vera steps in to calm the bride and fix Marnie's straps.
I'm getting a lot of different directions here.
Just relax. I want you to tell me which one is a looser and which one is a tight. Because you are in the dress.
Well, I don't know what's going on right now.
Will alterations manager Vera be able to save this seersucker selection?
You like it still here, over here?
There. I feel comfortable.
You feel comfortable? Is it better than the... Yes, it's comfortable. Do you see that?
No matter how zany a bride can act, we're always going to make sure that her gown is flawless.
I feel so much more comfortable. Thank you, Loretta.
You're welcome.
When buying a dress, most brides want the whole family involved. But when that includes the furry kind, the appointment can go to the dogs.
My name is Mary McLaughlin. My fiance's name is Scott. I just think he's perfect for me.
This is Mary's first time shopping, and what she wants to wear is not that outrageous.
I'm looking for something that kind of shows off curves.
What is outrageous is her next request.
I have two dogs. One is Gabby, and I would really love for Gabby to wear something that makes her feel special too.
haven't found that many places that will actually make something for Gabby, so I'm really excited that Kleinfeld is offering service for me to buy a dress for Gabby.
Listen, I treat my pup like a princess too. But for people who don't have dogs, they might think you've gone a little canine crazy.
We are actually choosing a headpiece to go on Mary's dog. So let's do that, and then let's do a little veil. Oh, that's brilliant.
Our dogs are our children. We refer to them as the kids.
Do you?
But before the doggies get dressed, their owner needs an outfit. Will this be the one?
I think this is amazing. I love it.
Mary loves this dress, but what will her group think?
Beautiful.
And to give Mary an idea of what she can do with her precious puppy, Randy brings out a very special model, his own little lady, Maggie.
I was thinking a little veil and a little tiara.
So cute.
So what do you think?
I think that would work for Gabby, as long as it could be secured around her head.
Cute. Oh my God, that's so cute.
Okay.
So we're gonna say yes to this dress?
I think we're gonna say yes to the dress.
Okay.
And for number one, we have a bride who doesn't just have one outrageous request. She has a whole slew of them.
My name is Mary Hawkins. My fiance's name is Brian Stillman. He's supportive, he's funny, he's like, he's great.
This bride has come for a fitting for a very interesting wedding ensemble.
Hello.
My dress is short. It has a big poofy red underskirt. It has glitter tulle underneath. I mean, look at this dress. I'm definitely an unusual bride.
And this next addition should really add to the fun.
I'm hoping we haven't invited anybody who will storm out of the wedding because I'm wearing sneakers.
Sparkly red sneakers is an outrageous choice for wedding gear. But this bride is all about being carefree and comfy on her wedding day.
It's time for her final fitting, and although Mary loves her outrageous dress, she's nervous about her conservative future mother-in-law's reaction.
Oh my, Mary, you look incredible. You look perfect.
And let's not forget the crowning jewel of this gown.
Oh my God, look at the sparkles.
Oh,
it's
my
gorgeous.
God, Mary.
You love it?
I love it.
Okay. I'm hoping everybody who sees it will go, that's unusual, but it's really cute and it fit her. This is so beautiful. It's so perfect.